Kingston Rule's coming home very stoutly.
A remarkable chapter in racing history had its beginnings on the golf course. And if not for the persuasive powers of an Aussie sporting legend, three champions may never have graced our tracks. Norman von Nida, three-time Australian Open champion and winner of 48 tournaments around the world, had two sporting passions. One was golf, the other was thoroughbreds. Strolling the links one day with hedge fund manager David Haynes, von Nida convinced the businessman to become a horse breeder. Haynes invested in Kingston Park in Victoria and charged von Nida with finding quality broodmares. The retired golfer headed to Italy, securing six mares from the Dormello stud established by Italian breeding legend Federico Tessio. One of those mares was Ada Hunter, a granddaughter of the unbeaten Italian horse of the century, Rebo. She would eventually produce one of Australia's greats.
But the real Kingston Town's going to street them, and Kingston Town's gone on to win by four lengths.
Kingston Town won three Cox Plates and 14 Group 1s on his way to the Hall of Fame as the first million-dollar earner of the Australian turf. In 1982, with the Caulfield Stakes and Cox Plate already under his belt, Kingston Town lugged the huge burden of 59 kilos in the Melbourne Cup.
And Gurnas Lane on the inside might beat them all. Gurnas Lane has got up to win the cup. He came through to beat Kingston Town a neck.
It was a mighty run by the champ, one of his best, even in defeat. And while Kingston Town was being celebrated as one of the country's best, a stablemate was forging her own reputation. Rose of Kingston was another outstanding progeny of the Tessio Kingston Park collaboration. She won the VRC Oaks in 1981 before becoming the first filly in 38 years to beat the colts in the AJC Derby. On retirement, she was paired in the paddock with American Triple Crown winner Secretariat. The foal was a handsome colt, a dead ringer for his champion dad, and he was given the name Kingston Rule. After little success in France or then Australia, where he was originally under the guidance of TJ Smith, he transferred to the stables of Bart Cummings, and on the first Tuesday of November in 1990, with Darren Beatman aboard, he secured a place in history.
Kingston Rule in front, the Phantom trying to get up on the inside, but it's Bart's eighth cup, and Kingston Rule wins the Melbourne Cup.
Cups King, Bart Cummings, eight Melbourne Cups, how does it feel?
Well, it's better than one, better than seven, it's terrific, really.
Kingston Rule set a race record that still stands 30 years later.